Hi, I'm Robin with First Class Fundraisers. The reason we call ourselves First Class is we only sell the absolute best things in fundraising. You're about to find that out for yourself. Now, the reason we own a fundraising company, because my husband and I own it, the reason we own it isn't because on career day in sixth grade, somebody said, what do you want to do? And you said you wanted to be a doctor, and someone asked you and you wanted to be a vet. It isn't that somebody asked me what I wanted to do and I said, I want to own a fundraising company. Nobody does that, right? The reason that we own a fundraising company is because we were exactly where you are right now when we were your age. We had to raise money and we had to do it selling really bad stuff. People came up and told us that the stuff we were going to be selling was just amazing, and they'd show us a brochure and we'd just get to see it. And you trust them, right? Because you need to raise the money and you want to do a good job. Well, everybody knows that the problem with most fundraising is when you look at it in the catalog, it looks like it's going to be this big. And how big is it when it comes in? It's like this, you know? Or they say it's amazing, the best thing you'll ever taste. Tastes just like homemade. And when you taste it, does it taste like homemade? No, not unless your mom's a really bad cook. So, the reason we own a fundraising company and call it First Class is because of those kinds of experiences. We decided that we wanted to do fundraising a different way. Because we were your age and because we had to do really lame fundraisers, we decided that nobody should have to do fundraising that way anymore. Now, two of my least favorite fundraisers of all times, the first was I had to sell calendars. Now, it isn't that I hate calendars. I use one almost every day of my life. But the calendars, the booster group decided to sell them in about February. We started around Valentine's Day, and I took orders for the calendars. They were $10 each, and I sold a bunch of them to pay for my trip. I was going to Marriott's Great America, which is up around the Chicago area, and it's sort of like a Six Flags or a King's Island. I sold a bunch of calendars to pay for my trip because my parents wouldn't write the check. They said it built character in me to do it myself. And they were right, it did help me, but at the time it really upset me that I could work so hard to do something and somebody else's parents would just write a check. But in the long run, it did help me, so I guess I owe them a thank you. Now these calendars though were $10 a piece and I had to sell a bunch of them to pay for my trip. In February, not many people want to buy a calendar. The calendars were supposed to be delivered in April. Got them out, got them delivered to our customers, and then we noticed that there was a typo on the calendar. We had to get it reprinted. By the time the printer brought them back to us, it was May. Now, nobody still wanted a calendar in May. People that were nice enough to order it in February from me were really upset with me when I delivered it. Now, that taught me one thing about fundraising. There's a good time to sell things and a bad time to sell them. You guys are selling at a perfect time because guess what? Everybody eats all year round. And this stuff is so good that anybody would love to buy it from you any time of year. Now, the first step then was to make sure you're selling something that's good at a good time. The second step, the second least favorite fundraiser, was taught to me about candles. Now these candles weren't really cool like candles are now. I realize that now like you can buy candles at the convenience store. Every place sells candles. And they're like all sorts of cool scents. Like you get mango chutney and linen, clean linen vanilla lavender and all sorts of really cool colors and designs. Now candles weren't like that when I was your age. I'm from back in the covered wagon days because I'm really old. Okay, that was a joke. You're supposed to laugh. But seriously, candles were just basically a plain white wax candle in a clear glass jar. Now stay with me here. The only decorative thing about the candle was an old Christmas card that these people had taped around the outside of the jar. The candles were $5 each. Our group got $1 for each candle we sold. And I sold a bunch of these candles. I decided from the brochure when the guy came and talked to us, hey, I can sell these candles. It was an old Christmas type scene with a snow village with a horse-drawn sleigh and a little picture of a church and things. And there were four different pictures. Now, I went out and I sold the candles
and was really excited about it. I said, "Hi, I'm Robin from Hinsdale Township High School, and I'm really hoping you can help me on my fundraiser." And people were like, "Well, what are you selling?" And I said, "I'm selling these candles." And they looked at the brochure, and they were kind of impressed by what I had to say, and they bought a candle from me. I got the candles order turned in. I got the money turned in. Went out and delivered my candles when they finally got there and thought I was golden because I had paid for my trip. A couple weeks later, I start getting phone calls. When people light the candle, a little dark spot appeared on the horse's head in the snow scene. And then pretty soon, the paper is on fire. The candle burned so hot, it actually ignited the paper through the glass. People were understandably upset because remember, the candle doesn't smell good or look good other than that cardboard. So people were like, "We need our money back." And I was like, "I am so sorry. I'll take care of it." And I went back and talked to Mrs. Votaw, my director, and I said, "We have to do something." And Mrs. Votaw called the candle company, and guess what the candle company said? "Sorry, you've already paid." I was like, "What? If I own that company, there's no way I would not stand behind my product. There's no way I would make the kid go back out and tell people, sorry." But that's what I had to do. So then the next year I went in for my fundraiser and I'm like, "Please not candles, please not candles." And guess what we're selling? Candles. And I'm like, "I can't sell these candles again." And then I looked at the brochure and I was like, "Hey, I have changed the world. Look, the candles are different. Now instead of having the cardboard around the outside, they've painted the glass. And now there's one that has like a stained glass window and one that has a dove and one that has a Christmas tree." And I'm like, "I can sell these candles." And I went back out and I said, "Hi, I'm Robin from Hinsdale Township High School, and I'm really hoping you can help me on my fundraiser." And what did the people say? "Hey, aren't you that girl that sold us a candle last year?" And I'm like, "Yeah, but look, the candles are totally different. They listened to us. They changed it." The people listened to me. They bought a candle from me, and I got my candles orders in, got the money in, got my candles delivered, thought I was golden. Couple weeks later, phone calls from the customers. When they light the candle, the paint flakes off the outside of the jar wherever it gets hot. "I cannot win with this candle company." I go back to Mrs. Votaw, my director, and I ask her what we can do. And she calls the company, and the company doesn't even return our phone calls. Now, you guys know as well as I do that that's the kind of thing about fundraising. That's the problem. People that don't stand behind their products, products that aren't that good to begin with, and having to make you sell from a brochure. That's what most companies do. That's why we do it differently. Now, the next year, I went in for my fundraiser. I was like, "Please not candles, please not candles." Guess what we were selling? Candy. I was like, "Yes, I can sell candy." And I went out and I said, "Hi, I'm Robin from Hinsdale Township High School, and I'm really hoping you can help me with my fundraiser." And what did people say? No? Why did they say no? I wasn't selling candles. They said no because they didn't trust me. That's the problem with fundraisers. It's not just what you've sold them before. It's other fundraisers that they've been ripped off by. Now, this stuff is different because we actually care about our products. Remember how I said it's first class? We actually only sell the absolute best stuff there is. We go out and we find food that is so good that people are going to want to buy it. That's step one. Step two is it has to be priced fairly so that people can afford it even when the economy is bad. So that you can make a good profit and we can make a good profit too. And the customer gets a quality product. Now step three is a little bit harder. I have to convince you of how good it is. Now, I'm not a good enough salesperson that I can stand up here and tell you that this tastes like homemade when it really doesn't, all right? Because everybody tells you that, and is it true? No. Unless your mom's a really bad cook, their stuff doesn't taste like homemade. Now, when you taste our stuff, which you're about to do, because we have samples up here for you, I want you to take it and realize how good it is. Does it leave a funky aftertaste in your mouth? No, it doesn't. It's made with premium ingredients, and it's only the best of stuff that there is. On your cheat sheet here, because I'm the mom of five kids, I want to make it easy for you. I have everything that you're going to need to know about the fundraiser. Across the top, it says who's selling. Then it says the products that you're selling. On the left side, by the little check mark that says the items are guaranteed delicious, it tells you a little bit about the product, so you can just read it off to people if you get tongue-tied. The little picture with the bow on it is to remind you that things make great presents, so people can actually shop for their Christmas list or birthday gifts or anniversary gifts and have awesome things to give people that they can't buy for themselves. Bottom left corner, the two guys hoisting the sign, it tells you when your turn-in date is. Top right corner, it tells you when your delivery date is. This stuff is going to come frozen. You have about a 6 to 8 hour window to get it back into a freezer. Now, we deliver it on our own fleet of delivery trucks that have freezers so that you don't have to worry about it being thawed before it gets there. But once it gets there, you do need to be there to get your stuff, and you do need to take it home, deliver it to your customers, or get it back in your freezer, okay? Because what happens to something that's frozen when you take it out of a freezer? It thaws, right? Right. Or it melts, yeah. This stuff is all frozen. It has about a 6 to 8 hour window before something bad's gonna happen. But you do need to get it back to your customers or get it back in a freezer. Now, there are incentives, things that you're gonna wanna do, things that you're earning for, that your director or your teacher is gonna go over with you. Two of the fundraising incentives that we do for all of our students is we have a tub of cookie dough that we give for every 20 items you sell, okay? And I know as soon as you get this cookie dough, you're gonna take it right home and bake it up into cookies, aren't you? No? Okay. Remember I said I'm the mom of five kids? How much cookie baking do you think goes on in my house? Zero, okay? You guys have won me over to the dark side. I realize that you're gonna spoon and eat this cookie dough without baking it. Now your mom's gonna go, oh, don't eat that. You're gonna get salmonella. And you're gonna go, au contraire, ma mère, because in addition to being brilliant like you are, you also speak French fluently. You can tell her that it's safe to spoon and eat right there on the label. We make it with pasteurized eggs, so you guys can eat it raw. And it's harder to make it taste good raw or baked, but we do it. It'll be M&M or chocolate chunk, and it'll be packed right in with your order. And the second incentive that we do for all of our students is right there in the middle of your sheet. It says $1,000 college scholarship. Now that's for college, trade school, or any post-secondary education or career goal that you have. We have five kids, and that's a lot of college to pay for. So we decided what would help busy parents want to help you. And we decided that college money is what could help. So this money will be banked whether you're a senior in high school or a middle schooler or an elementary school student. One student in the state of Indiana that sells the most number of items this year is going to win that scholarship. Now the average top seller is between 125 and 150 items, okay? That is totally doable for you guys. You could sell that many things in one afternoon if you really put your mind to it. Top left corner, it says students and, what's that next word? Parents? Okay, I want you to take this home and give it to your parents. If you don't do anything else, make sure this stuff gets home to your parents. Make sure that you tell them about the products. Make sure you tell them about how it tasted. They're going to take it to work with them, post it in the break room. People will sign up to buy stuff. And I promise you that when they do, they're going to thank you because it's so good, they're actually going to want more. Thank you and good luck in selling.